Don't miss out on the special offer from my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They're currently giving you 20% off if you use my coupon code POODLE at checkout, and also giving you an additional 10% coins at checkout. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, and today I'm going to be going over a little bit of the market. I did do one yesterday, but I think I missed out a key point in yesterday's video that I'm going to go over now upon seeing some new sets and some other stuff. I did mention this in the video that you guys probably just saw posted. So if you saw that one already, you can skip through this a little bit. I don't want you guys to think it's repetitive. It's just that I think I need to cover this in a specific market video because that typically draws out a lot of guys who care about the market. And my other video might not, so I'm not going to really get this to the people that I need to get it to right now that really care about this. So first thing is that before I get into the video, guys, make sure to type down below 500K and drop a like. Like I can saying, if we hit 150 likes in any video, I will be giving away 569,000 coins to a random commenter. Very simple, guys. In that little short sentence, you could have already liked it, so go like it down below. Also, if you're new, drop a sub, because I'll be doing giveaways in every single video from today all the way until Madden 20 drops July 26th. So if you guys haven't already, go sub, drop a like, drop a comment, and once we hit 150 likes, I will be giving away the coins, then I'll move on to other players on my team. Now, so I was going through my last video, and I came upon this new set, which I talked about, so I'm not going to go into detail on it. It is a Position Heroes collectible set. It guarantees you a 99 overall auctionable and tradable position hero card that is not good for the market, only because people have been asking me, this is why I'm addressing this, people have been saying, should I sell my Ramsey, should I sell my T.Y. Hilton, and I was telling them, they may not go down right now, they'll keep face value for a little bit, but not anymore. First off, Madden's at a point where they don't really care about their own game or their market, all they're trying to do is squeeze out the last bit of average player time and coins and money spending they can get out of you guys. So right now, they're going to keep giving you shit just to get you guys right back. So if you haven't realized, they've been giving away the most free stuff that I've seen all year in the last 3 weeks with house rules and the free 99s. So in house rules, they're giving you a free 99 positional hero. This set's going to give you a free 99 positional hero. I imagine house rules also going to give you another free 99 positional hero next week. And in the house rules this week, you also got two 94 plus fantasy packs that could have given you a positional hero. And to make it all worse, half these sets are easy to do. These sets take power of players. Look, if I go into Jalen Ramsey's set right now, I have it done already. Literally, I could do this in about 10 seconds with cards that I have sitting in my binder that are NAT and powered up to get a 99 overall corner. It is too easy to acquire these cards right now. So I do not think they will hold value. I think that if you can sell them, I'm going to go to the market and tell you guys what they're sitting at right now. So I can give you a decent example of where I think they will be, where they're at, and what you should expect. I don't expect them to go up much more than they're at right now. Maybe later in the year, but at that point, who really cares? I mean, you're trying to make your coins now, right? So I go over to Position Heroes, 159. Yeah, they're 99 overall for 159. Do you guys understand how cheap that training is? Like, I mean, let me break out this math real quick. I just need to know for my own health. I need to see what this is right now. 48. This is their training's about to be below 3 coins per, which is unreal at this point. It's almost gonna be, if you buy it, we're getting to the point in the year where literally whatever card you're gonna buy soon is gonna be how much training you get. So if you buy this card for 164,000 coins, you get 164,000 training. We're getting closer to that point. And there's gonna be a point when 99s are literally below 100k, and they're gonna be practically getting close. It's probably like 2 coins. I think it'll break at about 2 coins. It won't get worse than 2 coins, because if it gets worse than 2 coins per training, that means that the market's free. They're giving away cards at that point. So if I had T.Y. Hilton, I probably would not sell him just yet. I'd probably wait till later in the night, today or tomorrow. I wouldn't let it get to Saturday, but I would be getting rid of some cards slowly. Not yet, they're really hot right now. Some new ones just dropped. Also, house rules is about to give everyone a free 99. I don't know if it gave it to them already. It might have already, so that's probably why the market's dying. I would wait a day or two, probably. Just don't let it. I don't know if Saturday still gives you enough, but I definitely wait a little bit. Let them get back up to like 180, then sell. But next week's house rules combined with that set and everything else that's going on and new positional heroes every week, it's going to destroy the market completely. Everything's going to be down. If you have Jalen Ramsey right now, I'd sell him. Like I said, not at the moment. I'd sell him later tonight, or I'd sell him tomorrow night. Definitely do not hold on to these cards much longer. And now don't crucify me if they go up a few more extra 20k in a few days. They might. But don't hold on. What I'm trying to say is don't wait till next week. Like, sell them before another house rules happen and they guarantee it, or that set ends. Just make sure you sell them before then, because that's gonna kill it. And the more that gets dropped, the more there's an influx on the market. Like, just think about it, a 99 overall is getting sold for 159K. That's crazy. Like, that's unreal. A few weeks ago, 99s were at minimum 450K. Minimum. Now it's 155K, 100. And I know this is just a higher price right now. Give it a little bit. This might even be down to 145. You might even catch them for 130 if you keep looking all day. So the point is here is that I do not trust the position heroes. They are too volatile. Do not trust them. Stay on top of it. If you're going to hold on to one in your team, make sure before you get on, off, and while you're on Madden, be currently checking them to make sure nothing crashes on you guys, because you will lose a lot of coins. And for all you guys who commented down below, should I get rid of them? Yes. Now, if I get a Ramsey, will I keep it? Maybe, because I'm giving away my team and coins. I might just give it away to you guys. So don't be like, hey, why are you keeping your Ramsey? I'm probably going to give it away back to you guys, most likely. So the point is that what I do is a little different, just because I'm trying to give back right now. I'm not trying to make the coins, but I know you guys still grinding your teams out at this point in the year, and it's completely understandable. So don't rely on the positional heroes to make you money. If you got them, sell them. The worst thing Madden could have done was make all these positional heroes auctionable. Everyone always says, right? Oh, I'm so happy Madden didn't make it NAT. They made it auctionable. But making it auctionable is actually worse, because you're getting a card that was 300K. But the second everyone gets it, it's now 120 to 140K. So it kills the value on these cards. So it kills the promo practically. It pretty much kills the whole promo. If they give you free auctionable cards, the whole promo is dead. Now it hurts their pockets, honestly, it does. I prefer it NAT, right? I prefer it NAT for this one reason. I still get the card. It forces me to try out cards that I otherwise probably wouldn't try out, which I like. I like how it adds chance to the game. Like, I might never have used a T.Y. Hilton, but if I get it for free and it's not, I might actually use it on my team. So I think that's cool. Second, it keeps rarity in packs. So if I pull a T.Y. Hilton tomorrow, oh my God, I pulled a 300K pull early in the year, it would be 600K. If the Christmas promo gave us free 96 Ghost of Past for free, like a bunch of them, like house rules every week, those cards, we wouldn't have made millions off the promo. We wouldn't have been able to flip them for 600, 700K. They would have all been 200K. No one would have cared. It would have ruined the promo. So the promo gets temporarily killed because of this. And I don't think it's slowing down. I think it's going to keep going due to the point of the year that we're at. And that is not good for the promo. I know people don't agree with that. They like auctionable items, but I don't, because if everyone in Madden gets one, the majority of people in Madden get one, they're no longer rare. So what was so cool? If we got a NAT one, it's cool, because they're still rare on the auction block. Not everyone can have one, but if you did it, you have one. But now when they're auctionable, everyone has one, and they, you know, no one uses them. They'll go right to the auction block. The market crashes. People lose coins. People gain coins. You know, I'm not a fan of when they make things auctionable like that, at least to that degree. Like, not their brand new cards. Maybe do last promos, good cards, give them free now. You know what I'm saying? Makes more sense to me. I don't mind it, but if you get it, it's just 160K. I mean, it's not the most amount of coins in the world. It would have been cool if it still went for 300K. But I think that we have about, what, a month from now? About 2 months left of Madden 19. So at this point, they don't really care. They're going to toss you free things. It's like a dog bone. They're going to toss you the bone, let you chew on it for a little bit, keep you distracted for a little bit so you don't really see how shitty the game is right now. And that's all they're going to do, just keep you distracted. And then once they're done with you, get some money, and the new game comes out, and we start over again. So don't worry, I love that process though. I'm not gonna lie, I'm still gonna get the game. I'm not trashing the game at all. I'm just saying everything they're doing now is not good for the game. It's just gonna destroy the promo. Think about it. When have you ever seen 99 shop for a promo a few days ago and they're already at an all-time low? Like the Christmas promo, those cards held value and even went up as the promo went on. Like, there was a rarity to the new cards. Now these cards aren't exciting. Everyone has 99. Everyone's getting them for free. Everyone has them, you know what I'm saying? But that's about it, guys. Thank you for all the support as of late. I'm trying to stay on this grind. I'm really appreciating everyone that comes out every time for these videos. And if you're still here at this point in the video, don't forget to drop the like. 150 likes and I give away 569K. So it's very simple. Go like the video. And don't forget that I will be doing these every day from now until Madden 20. So you won't want to miss out. So I would just sub now. Get as much for yourself as you can. And if you win coins, maybe you don't play the game, right? You're like, I don't play the game. Well, I don't want coins. Take the 560K, go sell it to a coin sponsor. You can probably pull back a decent amount, $30 to $60, depending on how much they're buying for right now. So if I were you, either way you win. You could even get $30 to $60 and use that coins you sold from me to buy the next Madden. So I'm just saying, that's about it, guys. I hope you guys have been enjoying. Don't miss out on all these giveaways. It's going to be fun. You guys are going to get a lot of free cards, a lot of free coins, a lot of free everything. Won't want to miss out on that. And then if you sub, you're also here for Madden 20, hopefully. Hopefully you stay for Madden 20. It's going to be a great time, great content. A lot of the grind coming then. And if you guys are still here, yo, boys, drop a sub. Trying to get to a... My goal is 3K before Madden 20. Can we do it? We'll find out. But hopefully we can. And thank you guys for all the support. So that's it, guys. I'll see you in the next video. I'm out. See you next time.